speaking water. Water. Let's read verse 19. Hallelujah. You're ready to read 10 years. What is the scripture? Thou through thy commandments hast made me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. You know the easy way to overcome anybody is your wiser. Wisdom, you know that that is the crazy part. What of anything you do, you know what to do to overcome it. Is that not the truth? If the breaking and arrow is coming like this, no, just to it will fly over. May you know what you do to overcome any attack. The psalmist says, the only thing that gives me joy against all the enemies that are always ever with me is that I'm wiser than them. If they come this way, I know how to escape. If they do anything, I know what to do. If there is a foundational trouble, you are wiser than your foundational elders. If there is a period of anything in your family, if there is any ritual of covenant or dedication that puts people in bondage, you know what to do to escape it. Because every satanic ritual, they have the pyramid that will monitor it because they are not perfect. So you just know what to do. All that they have labored for all years is wisdom. One of the ministers that came out to minister, if I still remember, the food they went for evangelism, they had 7-day rituals. The whole village. And these children of God, they just passed by that village, and everything they did happened. And they arrested them to kill them. But what happened? The king, when they brought them to kill them, he said, can you hear your message? We did the church for 7 days. These people only passed by the village. And all the things happened. Don't you know they are stronger? You should seek the God you are strong. May you be wiser than your enemy. Hey, that's why this section is very important. Give it up. Why is this that they are ever with you? Remember me, the teacher, I just don't want to be tempted to teach. Your body composition is made largely of water. Meaning the enemy you pray about, you want to pray, they are watching and spying. They are always with you, but you can be wiser than them. May God give you wisdom. Therefore, lift up your voice and say, lift up those things and say, Holy Spirit is after now, through thy commandments, have made me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. Say, Holy Spirit, my counselor, by your counsel, I am wiser than my enemies, and I prevail over them. Holy Spirit, my counselor, by your counsel, I am wiser than my enemies, and I prevail over them. Holy Spirit, my counselor, by your counsel, I am wiser than my enemies, and I prevail over them. In the mighty name of Jesus. Read the next verse 99. Thank you, Jesus. I have more understanding than all my teachers. So thy testimonies are my meditation. So he said, wisdom, not understanding. May you have more wisdom than your enemies. May you have more understanding than your enemies. That's the way to be victorious. Now pray for that. Lift up those two hands and decree this week of it. I have more understanding than all my teachers. For thy testimonies and my meditations. Based upon this eternal word of God, the Holy Spirit, you are my teacher. Thank you for instructing and equipping me to excel above all my fellows. Holy Spirit, my teacher, instruct me, equip me above my fellows. Holy Spirit, my teacher, instruct me, equip me above my fellows. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, my teacher, instruct me, equip me above my fellows. In the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, my teacher, instruct me, equip me above my fellows. In Jesus' name, and verse number 100, what's this description? I understand more than the ancients because I kept them with me. Have you seen a boy of 8 years? People of 98 years just coming for your wisdom. May God make you wiser than the nations. May you be wiser than your foundation of the covenant. Meaning, a covenant that has been done 10 generations before you. And nobody will have to take it off. You just pray and say, hey, in Jesus' name, and the whole thing comes up to bless you. If you add the two pieces, and one side of them. May God make you wiser than your traditional elders. Because the God whom you serve is the essence of the universe. You therefore declare, my eternal Father, the ancient of days, thank you for making me wiser than my foundational elders. My eternal Father, the ancient of days, thank you for making me wiser than my foundational elders. I will become a laughter. I am wiser than my foundational elders. In the name of Jesus, I am wiser than my foundational elders. In the name of Jesus, I am wiser than my foundational elders. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Somebody say, I am wiser. I'm more prosperous than my foundational elders. Listen, this is important. Let them bring the history and the record of your family, father's side, mother's side, two laws, put them together. Your family, you will be rich, you will be wealthier than all of them together. Oh, that somebody is going to be better than that. If they say, oh, this is the good thing, the thing that is the richest in your whole family life, you will be richer than that person. You better get what you see because you're starting the riches of this. I know people have even had some guys who tell them to say, I heard your father say, all the wealth my generation will be used is the one you need. And the children are educated that the world and well connected, they are not making it. I told them that I said, I heard your father say, break that out. So I don't know what kind of who has gone in your family to enjoy the wealth of everybody. Your home is not inclusive. Because your riches is hidden in Christ. Therefore, you better decree. You want it directly to be established and together. The riches in your bloodline, you are richer than them. In glory, in honor, and in blessing, in wealth.
Say, I am wiser and more prosperous than my foundational elders. In the name of Jesus, I am wiser and much more prosperous than my foundational elders put together. In the name of Jesus, because I serve the ancient of days, I am therefore wiser and more prosperous than my foundational elders. In the name of Jesus.
Amen. You look at some families. When you mention the name, they were wealthy. Whether they are your children, who in this community has passed their wealth?
Rockefeller.
If you look at your life, who am among their family is richer than them? If there is a limit to their rich life, after this wealth, nobody passed their wealth. You better take this escape. I know what I'm talking about. People will be wealthy in your family, and after them, the news of everybody's crop is erased, not your own. You better decrease it by the decree of the only one of Israel. I, David Komolafe, I am wiser and much more prosperous than my foundational elders. In the name of Jesus, I am wiser and much more prosperous than my foundational elders. I did become a laughter in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I am wiser and much more prosperous than my foundational elder. In all my family history, in all my family records put together, I did become a laughter in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I am wiser and much more prosperous than all my foundational elders. In Jesus' name, you receive and believe that faith. Verse 101. If you want to prosper, you must not miss the mark. If you must prosper, you must not miss the mark. Read it, say it is already there. I have refrained my feet from every evil way, that I might keep thy word. And the church says, therefore you will lift up your voice. So I depend. You are depending to your feet now. Because you say, I have refrained my feet. So I depend to my feet. Be withdrawn from all evil paths, from the way of darkness, from the way of affliction, from the way of tragedy. I decree to my feet. In Jesus' name, you are withdrawn from the way of affliction, from the way of darkness. In Jesus' name, blood of Jesus, withdraw my feet from the way of darkness, from the way of sin, from the way of evil, from the way of iniquity. The fire of the Holy Ghost, withdraw my feet, withdraw my hands, withdraw my feet from evil path, from the path of destruction. Blood of Jesus, hey, you better touch it and begin to prophesy to that your feet. Blood of Jesus, withdraw my feet from destruction. Holy Ghost fire, withdraw my feet from destruction. Angels of Jehovah, withdraw my feet from destruction. In the name of Jesus, my feet will not walk in the path of destruction. My feet will not walk in the path of affliction. In the name of Jesus, let the fire of the Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost fire, withdraw my feet from death and tragedy. Blood of Jesus, remove my feet from the path of death and tragedy. In Jesus' name, blood of Jesus, remove my feet from the path of death and tragedy. Holy Ghost fire, withdraw my feet from destruction. Blood of Jesus, withdraw my feet from affliction. Holy Ghost fire, withdraw my feet from curses and spell. In Jesus' name, blood of Jesus, withdraw the feet of every member of this garden from death and tragedy. Blood of Jesus, withdraw the feet of every member of this garden from sin and iniquity. Blood of Jesus, withdraw the feet of every member of this garden from calamity. In the name of Jesus, blood of Jesus, withdraw the feet of every member of this garden from affliction, from curses, from spell. In the name of Jesus, let's begin to prophesy to that your feet. Now, you can be by this Sabbath. In Jesus' name we pray. Lord of Jesus, order my feet unto blessing. Holy Ghost Father, order my feet unto blessing. In Jesus' name, by the decree of the Holy Lord of Israel, my feet, you are ordered to blessing. You are ordered to favor. You are ordered to blessing. You are ordered into path of righteousness. In the name of Jesus, the feet of every member of this garden, the order to blessing, the order to righteousness. In the name of Jesus. Amen. And verse number 103 of the scripture. The Bible says, how sweet are thy words unto my case, yea, sweeter than the honey to my mouth. Based on that, we are going to come up. I receive the sweetness of God's word into my life, and I cannot be bitterness cast out of my life. Oh God, there is power in the word of God. That no bitterness has been there. So I receive the sweetness of the word of God into my life, and I command bitterness get out of my life. Confusion get out of my life. You need to come out what you want together. I receive the sweetness of the word of God. Hey, I receive the sweetness of the word of God into my entire being, spirit, soul, and body, and I command bitterness get out of my life. Corruption, pollution get out of my life. In Jesus' name, let the sweetness of the word of God begin to enter into the heart of every member of this garden, and bitterness be done. In Jesus' name, if you read the book of Exodus chapter 15, verses 23 and 25, in the joining of the children of Israel, after they crossed the Red Sea, what happened? They came across bitter water. Read verse 23. And when they came to Mara, they could not drink of the waters of Mara, for they were bitter. Therefore, the name it was called Mara. And verse 25 was the scripture. And he cried unto the Lord, and the Lord showed him a tree, which when he had cast into the waters were made sweet. There he made for them a statute and an ordinance, and there he put them. And in the next verse, and the Lord made a covenant of healing upon the people, saying, I am the Lord that healed you. Meaning, most sicknesses is as a result of bitter water in the system. You did not get bitter water into your life. God work? He said, the solution was they put a tree. That tree was the symbol of the cross. When the cross of Jesus entered into any situation, the bitterness there will be gone. Therefore, you can raise up your right hand and you are going to command sin by the power of the cross of my Lord Jesus. Every bitter water in my life, you are flushed out in the air. If you don't want to experience any sickness, you better pass it out. By the power of the cross of my Lord Jesus, bitter water in my life, you are cast out. Cast out. Now, in the name of Jesus, by the power of the cross of my Lord Jesus, I command bitter water out of my spirit, out of my soul, out of my body. In the name of Jesus, amen. Listen, this is no coincidence. The covenant of healing is that I am the Lord that healed you. After you came to the kind of out of everything, the Lord said, what was it to you? If you want to be healed, get bitter water out of your system. Devote your body situation. They do not try to water your body to bitter water. That's why they say they discover something. They see something. And something happened in the body. What did you say in verse 26? For I am the Lord. All he did was to put a tree there. This is the symbol of the cross. But the power of the cross, the Bible says the preaching of the cross to those that believe is power, to them that perish the foolishness. You don't want to preach. This is not your. Those believing God for healing and to live a healthy life, this is your time. Better wake up in your spirit. Lift up those lights and say, by the power of the cross of Jesus, this is our time. Cast out of my life. In the name of Jesus, let the power of the cross of Jesus pass bitter water out of my life. Out. In the name of Jesus, by the power of the cross of Jesus, I command bitter water cast out of my life. Get out. Let the power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my system. Let the power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my spiritual and body. In the name of Jesus. Oh yes. Let the power in the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my spirit. In the name of Jesus. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my soul. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of every cell of my body. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my business. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of every organ of my body. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water out of my bodily system. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus remove bitter water from the crown of my head unto the sole of your feet, unto the sole of my feet. In Jesus' name. The power of the cross of Jesus. 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 Remove bitter water out of my life. Bitter water. Be gone. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And by the power of the cross of Jesus, I decree healing into your life. In Jesus' mighty name. Since man is about water, but Jeremiah chapter 51, verse 13, look up to me. He said, all that are dwellers of the many waters, abundant in truth, your end is come to the measure of your possessions. Based on this, what is the mightiest reason water to attack your life? If they want to summon people to this water, they as long as water is in the body, it's swimming and the fish are there in the water. Look, you may be about them right now. Therefore, lift up your voice and decree. Read the thing, it's right here. Oh, thou that dwellest upon many waters, upon thousands of treasures, your age is come, and the measure of your conversions is.
based upon this eternal word of God, I command the rage of waters, the rage of waters, and the water spirits against my life, be consumed by the Holy Ghost fire. In Jesus' name, the rage of water, the rage of water spirits against my life. Holy Ghost fire, consume, in the name of Jesus. And you got the brother, the good as well. The rage of water, the rage of water spirits against my life. The blood of Jesus rebuke and condemn. Holy Ghost fire, drive out this water, consume this water. Resurrected Jesus, as you walk upon the water, prevail over every attack and the rage of water against me. Resurrected Jesus, as you walk upon the water, destroy every water spirit attack against this guy. Resurrected Jesus, as you walk upon the water, destroy every attack of water against this guy. In Jesus' name, resurrected Jesus, as you walk upon the water, destroy every attack and the rage of water spirit against this guy. Destroy, consume, attack of water spirit. And the personality and the weapons of water spirit attack, and they are raised against this guy. Let God arise and consume them. Holy Ghost, consume. They are raised this place in Jesus' name. And they got bigger people with the devil in their mind. Let the Father of the Holy Ghost drive out this rage of water spirit over this guy. Blood of Jesus, destroy this rage of the water spirit over this guy. Blood of Jesus, quench the rage of water spirit attack over this guy. Holy Ghost, quench the rage of water spirit attack over this guy. Holy Ghost, in the name of Jesus, quench the rage of water spirit attack against this guy. He shall not prosper. Water spirit attack against this guy. Holy Ghost, quench. Consume them to their roots. Consume them to their foundation. In the name of Jesus, personality of the waters attacking my life, you are overthrown to desolation. You are overthrown to desolation by the decree of the Holy One of Israel. Personality of the waters, spirit water that is attacking my life. The blood of Jesus overthrow you to desolation. Overthrow them to desolation. Overthrow them to desolation. Cast free the rage of water spirit attack against my life. Holy Ghost, overthrow them to desolation. The rage of water spirit attack against this life. The blood of Jesus. Overthrow them to desolation and bring them to nothing. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. And the church says, you are going to take it. Come to your spirit. Psalm 20, 29, verse number 3. What says the scripture? The Bible says in Psalm 29, verse number 3, it talks about the voice of the Lord upon the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon many waters. Shout it loud. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunder, the Lord is upon many waters. Much louder. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunder, the Lord is upon many waters. There is a plan of peace you are going to command. See, my glorious treasures trapped in the waters. Repeat, my glorious treasures trapped in the waters. Oh, voice of Jehovah. Bring them forth unto me now. In Jesus' name, all my glorious treasures trapped in the water. As it is written, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon many waters. Therefore, every good thing about me trapped in the water. Let the voice of Jehovah bring them forth. Bring them forth. All the good things about my life trapped in the water. Every good thing about my life trapped in the water. Hear the voice of the Lord. As it is written, the voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is upon many waters. Therefore, my glory, my beauty, my joy, every good thing about my life, trapped in the water. Oh, voice of Jehovah, bring them forth unto me now. Bring forth, bring forth, bring forth, bring forth, bring forth, bring forth, my and glory trapped in the water, the blood of Jesus will trap you and release you back onto me. In Jesus' name, by the voice of the Lord that is upon the waters, by glory upon the waters, come forth unto me now in Jesus' name. By the voice of the God of glory that conquered upon the waters, my glory and blessing trapped in the water, bring come forth unto me now in Jesus' name. By the voice of Jehovah that is upon many waters, my glory trapped in the waters, come forth unto me now in Jesus' name. By the voice of the Lord upon the waters, my blessing, my glory, every good thing about me, stand in the water. Come forth.
Amen. People have used this against many people. You better wake up. This is no joke. They will project into an object and speak. They use money, rock in the morning, project into it and go to the river and throw it to it. For that person to have money to spend for good things. The only time money comes is when some people know that I'm about to borrow or get something from you. Money will come. Because they have to get somebody that they can't The moment that you don't need to tell them, once the money lands, I'm going to get everything about you that the things are not just thrown into the water, you better call me for now. This is no joke. You better be it on us.
It is written. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory comes direct. The Lord is upon many waters. That is again. It is written. The voice of the Lord is upon the waters. The God of glory comes direct. The Lord is upon many waters. Therefore, my glory trapped in the water. Let the voice of Jehovah bring you forth unto me. In Jesus' name, by the voice of Jehovah upon the water, my glory trapped in the water. Come forth unto me. Tell us what. Come forth. Come forth. Come forth. Come forth. Now, in Jesus' name, by the voice of Jehovah that is upon the water, my glory trapped in the water. In Jesus' name, come forth unto me. Now, come forth. 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 Right now, in Jesus' name, by the voice of Jehovah that is upon the water, my goodness, every good thing about me, trapped in the water, by the decree of the Holy One of Israel, by the voice of Jehovah that is upon the water, good things about me, trapped in the water, in Jesus' name, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth, right now, in the name of Jesus, by the God of glory that came direct upon the water, every good thing about me, trapped in the water, let the voice of Jehovah bring forth, come forth, come forth unto me, right now. In the name of Jesus, because the Lord is upon many waters, by the voice of Jehovah that is upon many waters, my glory, my goodness, every good thing about me, my image, my glorious blessing, trapped in the water, by the voice of Jehovah upon many waters, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth, come forth unto me right now. In the name of Jesus, let the water release my glory. Let the water entrap my glory. Let the water entrap my blessing. Let the water release my blessing. In the name of Jesus, by the voice of Jehovah, that is upon many waters, the glory, the blessing, due to this darkness, in the name of Jesus, Christ of Nazareth, come forth, come forth, by the voice of Jehovah, that is upon many waters, the glory of this darkness, trapped in the water, in the name of Jesus, trap and trap, come forth, right now, come forth, 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 right now, in the name of Jesus, by the voice of Jehovah, that is upon darkness. Upon the waters. Every good thing about this life, wherever you are trapped in the waters, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, come forth right now, come forth right now, in the name of Jesus, by the voice of Jehovah that is upon many waters, every good thing about this life, wherever you are trapped, come forth. Lift up your voice. Mention the specificity, your joy of marriage, your health, your work with God, your giftings. Every good thing about you, your wealth, your health. Start in the waters. Command them to come forth, Roger. Command them to come forth. Hey, they can't snap it there. Wherever it's snapped, may the hand of Jehovah restore in Jesus' name. And the church says, the Bible says that the Spirit of God moves upon the day. We are going to say, Holy Spirit, move upon the waters and destroy them. And destroy evil projected against me from the water spirit. And destroy the evil projected against me from the water spirit. Holy Spirit, move upon the waters. And destroy the every evil projected against me from the waters. Destroy, 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 destroy. In the name of Jesus. Amen. The Holy Spirit, move upon the waters now. And let anything about water walk to my favor now. In Jesus' name. And the church says,